this contest is scheduled for one fall.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, here he comes again.
Here is.
And thus far, he is two for two.
What did you expect? Did you expect anything left out of this guy?
Ted DiBiase, the devious one. According to Ted DiBiase, everybody has a price for the $1 million man.
That's right. Listen up, McMahon.
Well, this is it. It's SummerSlam. And I don't have any idea what Paul Bearer is going to bring to SummerSlam tonight. But the $1 million man brings to you once again the one, the only, from the dark side, the Undertaker.
There's an eerie feeling for you, McMahon, huh? Goose pimples up and down your neck there?
Take a look if you want.
Yeah. Now, who does Paul Bearer have with him? Huh, McMahon?
Surely a one-of-a-kind matchup, ladies and gentlemen. The Undertaker versus The Undertaker. And I suggest to you, Jerry Lawler, that only one will survive.
That one right there. That's The Undertaker.
23,000 fans here at the United Center. What a presence they are currently feeling as Ted DiBiase's Undertaker makes his way to the squared circle. An ominous sight as The Undertaker takes the steps. And
oh yeah,
brings the light. The Undertaker, possessed by Ted DiBiase.
Don't you know it must be great to be rich, McMahon? Look at that. This guy's got bookcases at home just for his bank books.
But what will Paul Bearer bring to the squared circle? What will he bring to SummerSlam?
That's him right there, The Undertaker.
Yeah, but what will Paul Bearer bring?
Led towards the ring by Paul Bearer.
We're fixing to find out.
The one, the only, The Undertaker.
Oh.
There's Paul, but where's The Undertaker? What's he looking at over here?
Oh, wait a minute.
Paul Bearer is bringing the double wide, double deep casket. And you know what's inside that casket.
No, I don't know.
The Undertaker's in there.
The Undertaker's in the ring. Man, wonder who his embalmer is.
Inside that casket, ladies and gentlemen, The Undertaker. And I believe it's the same Undertaker that we last saw at the WWF Royal Rumble that will emerge from that casket, that will step into the ring and face The Undertaker.
Now, isn't that some statement to make? You believe that's The Undertaker that will step in the ring and face The Undertaker? The Undertaker.
How would you phrase it?
The Undertaker's in the ring so far. We've still seen nothing, absolutely nothing, from Paul Bearer.
Well, a
Watch this.
Tell you one thing. The Undertaker steps out of there, I'm leaving.
And here he comes! I fully expected the Undertaker to.
Oh my gosh, McMahon, he doesn't have an Undertaker. I guess he expects that urn to fight the Undertaker.
Well, for sure he's not going to come out of the urn. But what is going on here?
They're leading the casket away.
Wait a minute. Look at the look on Ted DiBiase's face. He cannot believe what he is seeing.
I cannot believe that sight right there, McMahon.
Yeah, it's like looking in a mirror. I think there is only one true Undertaker. And we're about to find out which one there is. This is the moment, ladies and gentlemen. we have all been waiting for. The mystery.
There's no mystery. There's no mystery now. There are two Undertakers. That's the ugly one there.
And now, here we go.
That is like looking in a mirror.
And look out! Yes! Paul Bearer's Undertaker going to work on Ted DiBiase's. But no one really, look at this. No one really knows what to expect. And a reversal. Look at this. Leapfrog by the Undertaker. Oh, my. Tremendous boot. And a chop into the outside. And Ted DiBiase now up on the apron and backing right back off as Paul Bearer's Undertaker, the Undertaker, I believe, approaches. Wait a minute.
Oh, yeah. Get that whatever that Paul Bearer is. Get him. And get
He's
that
going
urn.
After the urn.
It's all over for you.
Look out.
This is the most eerie sight. Oh, I think we've ever seen in the WWF. Look at this. The Undertaker. Oh, yeah. The suplex.
The Undertaker with a suplex on the Undertaker.
Wait a minute. He just set up. And look at that. Over the top to the outside. And Paul Bearer's Undertaker out on the outside and boom, to the canvas, the apron. Ooh, unbelievable chop. And I think thus far we have been able to determine that Paul Bearer's Undertaker, I believe, is the one who has returned, appears to be the more powerful of the two. And wait a minute.
Oh, yeah. That put a smile on DiBiase's face. That's his Undertaker. That's the real Undertaker right there.
This is very, very strange.
Come on, Undertaker.
Very, very strange.
Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Oh,
and
yes,
to
McMahon.
The top. And wait a minute. No. Paul Bearer's Undertaker. Has he by the throat, and yeah. That will certainly take its toll. And
look at him!
The sit-up.
The Undertaker sits right up, rises up, if you will.
And now, the Undertaker. Look at this, going to the top.
Wait a minute. Taker walks the ropes like that.
And down across the back.
You gotta admit, McMahon, both these Undertakers seem to have the power.
Indeed they do. And oh no, look at that. Both Undertakers having a go here. This capacity crowd in awe. They don't know what quite to think. They're seeing two Undertakers.
I don't quite know what to do. Whoa! Well, we know that only one Undertaker's gonna walk out of here.
Yes, indeed.
Doesn't look like it's going to be him, does it?
Not at the moment. And no! Missing with the elbow. And a clothesline. The Undertaker with a chop.
On the Undertaker.
And a headbutt. Paul Bearer's Undertaker. And no, they're missing with the clothesline there to the outside. You can hear the virtual silence of this capacity crowd. They're stunned.
Oh.
And we had no idea exactly what we were going to see. It's very eerie.
Well, now it's Paul Bearer's Undertaker who's stunned. Will you be willing to admit, McMahon, that whoever walks out of here is the Undertaker?
Absolutely. I'll grant you that.
All right. Then I'm putting my money on DiBiase's, whatever it is he's got. The million-dollar man and his men will find a way.
And the Undertaker is on the receiving end of a great deal of punishment here by the Undertaker.
That's right. Wait for that.
You figure it out. But wait a minute, look at this. Nothing really seems to be phasing Paul Bearer's Undertaker in there. I see a bit of frustration here on the part of Ted DiBiase's Undertaker. Off the rope, missing with a clothesline.
Uh-oh.
There it is.
And, oh!
Whoa, we saw it.
That could do it right there. He's not going for the cover.
Good night, Paul Bearer, and your Undertaker.
And nothing is happening. Uh-oh. That was a sit-up and a scoop here. Uh-oh, look out, here we go.
This is it.
Here comes the tombstone. Yes! No one will get up after that.
No one does that but the Undertaker.
Ted DiBiase, hold the hands. He's shouting to his Undertaker now.
That's it.
Whoa!
How did he rise from that?
Here comes yet another one. No! He can't believe. And wait a minute, look at this. The Undertaker, who just gave the Undertaker the tombstone, is going to give him another one.
Look at DiBiase, he can't believe it. Ted, if I were you. Oh!
And another one.
Wave some money. Paul Bearer's got that earned. Get that money out. Wave it.
This Undertaker is not sitting up at all.
What is he saying? One more tombstone?
And look out, here comes another one.
Oh!
Yes. And now, yes! We'll be right back. return to ringside. And look, The Undertaker has just thrown Ted DiBiase's Undertaker into the casket.
Three tombstones. He's finished.
For sure, there's only one Undertaker in all the WWF.